Hey, this is Diana, your favorite astro-nerd. It's time for another Dwarf Laugh giveaway video. And that was a very exciting process on this last video. The comments and just the live stream and the live draw, it was so amazing. We're going to do it again. We just need to get 3,000 views on the video and 100 likes. That's it. We got it in 9 days on my previous video. Let's see if we can do this faster so we can hopefully do a couple before Santa comes. And speaking of Santa's present, meet the winner of the first Dwarf II telescope giveaway, Victor Robles. Dale, Victor.
Hello, everybody. I'm Victor Robles from Victor Robles Photography. The winner of the first giveaway by your favorite astro-nerd. I just received the telescope today, and I want to thank Diana for her fun videos and the giveaway. I also want to thank Dwarf Labs for such a neat product, such a fun to use telescope. I'm looking forward to using it very, very soon here in my area. Thanks.
If you're getting itchy, like I need to buy a dwarf telescope, well, your favorite astro-nerd now has a promo code, which is 05astro-nerd, and it can be combined with other discounts at Dwarf Lab website or Amazon. So that means that they're going to give you some discounts if you want to purchase one. And in addition to that, with 05astro-nerd, you get another 5% discount. So go and get one, hurry. You're going to love it. In today's video, I am going to teach my grandchildren, Tristan, who is 7 years old, and Amberlyn, who is 6 years old, how to use the Dwarf II. They are going to set the Dwarf up and take photos of the moon.
Hi, I'm Tristan.
And I'm Amberlyn.
Today, I'm going to demonstrate the Dwarf II telescope. But before I start, we need to do one more thing. Take the dark frame. How are we going to hide the telescope?
We're going to hide in Papa's closet where it's very dark.
Now we're going to connect the telescope.
Now I found the telescope. It's connected, and we need to be sure that the lenses are down.
Now I'm going to put it in the bag in a real dark place. Be sure that's dark.
And we're going to put it in the darkest place, Papa's closet.
Now I'm going to hide it in Papa's closet.
Now we're going to press photo. After Astro, we're going to press function. Now that it's ready, I'm going to press OK.
Now the process is going to take 10 minutes, then it's done. The moon has water under the surface, and if you throw a ball on the moon, it will go 6 times higher than on Earth. Did you know that the moon doesn't have its own light, but the reflection of the sun? The moon travels around Earth 1 mile every 2 seconds. The moon doesn't change colors. It's always red. The moon is the largest satellite going around the Earth. I hope we can see craters with the dwarf telescope. We're going to photograph the moon with the Dwarf II telescope.
going to lower it. Okay, so now move that green little thing a little bit to that side. The other way. The other side. Like this. Like the other way. Like this. This way. Like there. Okay? Now go to focus. To the minus. Okay. So say I have to go the other way. Go plus. More.
Woo, I got it!
Not yet. Okay, so now that we have it there, we're going to start taking the photos, okay? And what I want to do is press on fits, the green one. Move this up to 140 or something. You do it now.
I'm gonna take 150 images of the moon. Jupiter is right next to the moon. I like to photograph it, but it's cloudy.
Kristen and Amberling, we're here for 6 days, so we have 6 nights to complete the imaging session. Unfortunately, it got cloudy every night. We tried several times, so Nana had to finish the imaging session, but Tristan and Amberling did an amazing job doing all the setup for the Dwarf too. Even a kid can do it. Okay. This looks like a horror movie. Okay, so now I am back to the moon. Let's just go here to functions and let's just keep moving shutter. And there we are. Let's see. I think last time it was like 1/6,000. That's pretty fast. Whoop. Okay, starting to look better and better. Let's see. Focus a little better. Let's see. Okay, there. And I don't have any experience photographing the moon. So let's just play a little bit with some of the settings. Probably the brightness is too much. And you know that I don't like to overexpose or over anything. No, so it's not plus. It's minus, but that tree, that branch is right there. I don't know, because the branch now decided to be right there on the way. I can see it. Come on, get out. So great. Now, okay, I guess we just have to wait a few more minutes. There you go, 5 stacked. I mean, this is very, very fast shutter, so interesting. So we'll see what happens in a little bit. Let's just leave it there. Exciting. This is the new feature, live stacking for the moon and the sun. So now we can see it. Still doing the stacking, so I need to wait until it finishes. I just have to be patient. I guess I cannot stop the process, but I think after some sharpening here, and adjusting the colors, it's going to look really good. Something that you have to do in astrophotography is to be patient. Sometimes we have to wait and wait and wait. And that's what happened when I was waiting for the moon to pass the trees for the second time. I started taking images of the 7 sisters, the Pleiades, which were right there posing for me. And this is one of the great things about the Dwarf telescope, that you can just move from target to target within minutes. So it's done, and look how beautiful. This is a very beautiful image. We have all those meteors. I am sure that's what it is there is some couple of meteor showers here. little bit lower. I saw they were going to be, but I believe that's what it is. So now it's time. The moon, it's getting very, very close. I wish I don't have to photograph the moon now. I was really enjoying this. So let's see. Let's just go live. Exposure time here, the shutter. Let's see on the 16 and let's work on the focus again. See? So manually, we're getting it. Working here on the tablet. Whoop! There's the tree. Super bright. It's just super bright. Getting less and less. That's probably the best I can do right now. Gain 80. We should lower this. Last night I had it at 40. So let's just have it at 30 to be safe. Going back to focus here. Now the tree's gone. So it will be like that, okay? And then obviously it's not going to look like that. We're going to work on it. It's better to go a little bit under exposure than overexposed, okay? Under, we can always fix. Overexposed, very difficult. You can, but it's difficult. Okay, so I'm going to try and have it at 20. One more time to focus here. I think that's kind of like the best. Yep, no. Let's go little by little. That's a great image. It's going to look very good. And I am using the astro mode to see the live stack. So let me just go back and put the IR filter. There you go. Let's just do 289 images. Very, very fast exposure. And let's just go ahead and start. Preview. Yeah, we want the stack. We want to see it binding 4K, which is one by one. Oop, somebody flew by. What was that? Okay, I'm telling you, the aliens are here. Okay. Let's just go ahead and start and see what happened. Okay, so it finished. That looks really nice. Oh, wow. Okay, so we'll see, compare with the other image with no filter. Sounds like somebody that I know. Okay, so this is kind of like what you're going to get once images are done. And in my case, I prefer just to get memory card and just put it right here in my computer using, of course, an adapter. I am going to, from my folder, I'm just going to copy it right here. And this is the grayscale first image, the first night that I took. So we're just going to close here. And we can kind of like compare if there is a big difference. And I think the one without the filter obviously looks much better. I mean, let's just compare right here. This one seems to be less sharp, and definitely the RGB image, it's sharper. And now let's have some fun editing in Pixinsight my image from the moon. It's going to be a very simple light editing because it really doesn't need that much. Okay, well, this is the second image. This is the one with the infrared filter. The only thing that I need to do on this one is to change this image to grayscale. And for that, I am just going to go here into image, and I'm using Pixinsight right now. Then I am going to go into color spaces, convert to grayscale, and there you go. Now we have our image. So if we look a little bit on Google and we see what people do with this type of images of the full moon, well, you can see all the variations. There's so many ideas. The new app, it's going to be amazing once Dwarf Lab finish tweaking and fixing some of the bugs that have been a little bit resistant to go away. I think they're going to officially release the new app any day. I really enjoy the new features. The 4K, it's amazing. I think images have definitely improved in quality and the higher resolution. The app, it's more user-friendly. Each step has now instructions, and overall the appearance of the app, it's more attractive. The star catalog, they added around 500 sky objects. I think the sky catalog, it's a big improvement, as it's easier for beginners. And the demonstration speaks for itself again. This is a telescope that it's very easy to use. Even a seven-year-old can do it. Now, Tristan is almost a genius. As you saw, he really is. And Amberlynn too. They're extremely intelligent. But they are kids, and it was very easy to show them the steps and to do the most difficult part. Tristan was able to do it, which is balancing the telescope and finding the object and focusing and everything. And he was so happy and so proud of what he did for this video. We can finish the imaging session and he can show all of you the image that he took. Thank you for watching, and see you soon with another video of Dwarf 2 Telescope. Thank you.